Hi, I'm Wayne Static.
I'm Tara Ray Static.
And
you're watching. What are we watching?
Tattoo TV.
Yeah. When you listen to the album, though, it's not like a real Stoppy Love album or anything. So how would you describe the inspirations?
Well, I mean, I don't write any sappy love songs ever, you know. So no one, some people maybe are scared when they hear that a lot of the lyrics are about my wife. But, you know, I mean, the first love song I ever wrote was about eating shit. So, you know, I don't write traditional love songs.
But we don't do that.
We don't do that, though. I wrote that song about somebody else, you know, their problems. but, you know, the record is definitely... you know, Static X, but it's a little bit darker and moodier than some of our previous things. And I started writing right after we got married. So she was on the couch masturbating the whole time I was writing and demoing the songs for the whole year. So I was very much inspired by her.
Can't help myself,
okay? Fair enough then. What do you think is better about this album then in comparison to all the others?
I just feel like this album really is the most personal stuff I've ever written, and I think it's the strongest and has the most dynamics, and it's really special to me because it's so personal.
Okay, and Dave Mustaine plays the guitars on the album version of Lunatic. What inspired you or prompted you maybe to get Dave Mustaine to play, considering the music of Megadeth is quite different to what Static X?
Well, I've been friends with Dave for 10 years. We've toured with him two times. And, you know, I'm a huge fan. Like, I've, you know, listening to Megadeth since the 80s, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So I just thought it'd be cool to have him play, you know. We had John 5 do a guest solo on Cannibal. So that's going to be kind of the new thing. I think we'll have, like, one guy come and do a solo or something. But I just, you know, asked Dave to do it, and he was into it. So it's an honor to have him on the record, definitely.
Cool. Well, here in Europe, this would probably be the biggest album you guys have brought out since Machine, which was 2001. Why... did you decide to maybe promote this a little bit better than you have?
It's not my decision. I have nothing to do with it. All I do is I make the records and then I hand them over to our label, and then it's out of my hands from there.
Okay.
So yeah, I can't, you know, we've come over and toured for every record, so we've done our part, and that's all I can say.
And you co-produce all of the albums. What have you learned over the years as a producer?
I've learned that I don't like making records very much. I used to think that maybe someday when I'm old that I might want to be a producer, but I don't see myself doing that.
Because I was just about to ask that, you wouldn't like to do any producing for the
bands?
No,
it's way too tedious, and it's just, you know, it's like 3 or 4 months of your life, you know, like every 6 days a week, you know, 8 or 10 hours a day. And I just don't have that kind of patience, you know.
Yeah, it's way too much work for me taking care of him during my time.
So I see myself maybe moving more into soundtracks when I'm older, but I mean, I'll always make music and, you know,
cool.
And all that.
And John Travis, actually, who produced some work for Monster Magnet, mm-hmm. and Buck Cherry, who also played Diamond for you, played it again. He worked as well with you on Cannibal.
Yeah.
Why did you choose to work with him again?
I had a great time on Cannibal. Someone thought, let's do it again. And I thought he did a great job on Cannibal. So
and he's hilarious.
He's a really funny guy. I've known him for 10 years as well, actually. He's good friends with my manager. And, you know, it just happened for Cannibal that we wanted to use someone different. And, you know, we thought, well, John could do a great job, so...
Because once again, the music that he's produced is really different to Static X.
Well, I thought that would
be
cool.
When you look at his portfolio.
I thought that would be really cool to actually bring someone in with a different perspective on things, you know, because I can produce the record myself if I want to. The whole reason to have a co-producer is to get a different opinion. So I think it is very helpful to have him in there with a, more of a rock and roll and punk rock sensibility.
To kind of have maybe an outside view of...
Exactly.
Yeah, excellent. So like all your albums, you will definitely probably co-produce just to have that outside.
Yeah, I'm a control freak. I have to, you know, have the final say on everything. And I mean, I write all the songs and everything, so, you know, I couldn't just let someone else take control of it. I couldn't do that ever.
Well, this is the only question that I'm going to ask about this particular issue, but do you feel, I mean, we haven't seen you guys over here since 2005 or something like that. Do you feel that maybe with all the unfortunate hassle that Trip Eisen caused the band, it has to be asked, do you feel that you really had to try build up your status again and it was quite hard to do so?
I think it hurt us a little bit in some ways. You know, mostly there's people still out there that think he's still in the band, and that's the biggest way that it's hurt us. And I know this for a fact. I've heard it. There's people that still think he's in the band. You know, maybe people that aren't like really hardcore fans of Static X and they don't keep up with things. You know, in some ways, you know, we're really happy to have Koichi back. So, you know,
he was the original guitarist.
Yeah, he was on the first album. And I mean, people don't know this, but Trip was on his way out anyway when he got arrested. I wasn't going to work with him anymore anyway.
Yeah.
You know, I couldn't.
I mean, he didn't even record like one of the biggest albums, Machine.
He wasn't on that. I've actually played all the guitars in that album.
How was the reception this time, and how, you know, it's a little bit different. It's in this great new venue that, like, it has to be said, actually, this venue, so many hardcore bands are coming over to play. How's the reaction from the fans been so far?
You know, it's been good. It's hard to judge, you know, because we're opening for Down on these shows, so it's a lot of their fans and some of our fans, so, you know, it's hard to tell, but, I like the opportunity to play for other people's fans and win them over, and, you know, that's how we've grown in popularity over the years, so... the beginning, you know, it's like a lot of old school Pantera fans there to see Phil, you know.
Yeah.
And then, you know, they're all, you know, kind of skeptical because I look like an idiot, you know. And but we win them over by the end.
Okay, another big tour that's coming up is Pedal the Metal. Do you want to tell me a little bit about that? You're playing with the bands like Mudvayne and the Black Label Society.
Black Label Society.
What made you decide those guys?
Well, they made us an offer, and again, I'm friends with every band on the tour, and
because you're very funny about who you tour with, aren't you?
I am. Yeah. I won't open for someone that I don't think is an awesome, great band.
Like, really?
I refuse to, even if they're bigger than us.
Yeah.
If I don't like them and I don't think they're awesome, I won't open for them. Because we can go do our own headline tours. We don't have to open for anyone.
Mm.
So I think it's a great bill, and you know, I'm friends and a fan of all the bands on that bill. So it's going to be an awesome tour. It's going to be a lot of fun.
And are you planning on doing any headline tours maybe throughout Europe? Because we've had to wait a while. I keep going on about this, but we have had to wait many years. And that's why so many people are excited right now that you're
back. I know.
There.
We've had a lot of misfortune. I mean, we were actually here in 2007.
Mm-hmm.
And again, we had bus problems and had to cancel a bunch of shows. And
I think you need to get a new bus.
It's not our fault. The buses here suck. We got a great bus this time,
okay.
So we're not going to miss any shows this time.
Hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully. The buses here are terrible, man. I don't know. Like, any band you talk to, that you ask them about the buses compared to the U.S., and it's ridiculous, you know?
Well, what's the future plan of Static X?
Well, I already started writing, I mean, before the album came out. I'm always writing. If I'm not on tour, I'm writing or recording, so I don't take vacations. So there's no time for that.
And do you think that the next album in the future will have the same sound, or we'll have to wait and see?
It's too early to tell. You know, right now it's just like a lot of beginning ideas of songs and, you know, that type of thing.
Maybe the Killer Bees will inspire it a bit.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll kind of see where it goes. You know, it takes me a while to really figure out. I have to have a whole bunch of songs written really to figure out which direction I want to push it in.
Cool.
But, you know, the last two records I think are great, so, you know, it might stay in that vein.
Moving on to your tattoos.
Mm-hmm.
You only got tattooed recently.
Yeah.
After you guys got married. Oh, was it before?
It was after. Yeah, first was...
Right when we got married, we got this one, which is Eternal Love in Japanese. And a lot of people, you know, get rings and whatever, but you can take rings off. I think tattoos are just more permanent and special.
I mean, we have
special.
Rings, too.
We have rings, too. But
they're very hardcore-looking rings.
Yeah. Well, we decided to only spend a few $100 on rings and then buy a new car, too, instead of, like, really expensive rings. You know?
Cool. And,
and then we have the other one, which is our zodiac symbols together.
I'm Aries, and he's a Scorpio.
Yeah. And we got them this way because then when we're holding hands, they'll always be together.
Yeah. Aww. Stop it. Seriously. Stop being all alone.
I'm going to make him get some more of those.
And you have one on your stomach as well.
I have one on my stomach. It means Southern Comfort, which is that right there. And I also have more. I just got some more added to it, actually, and I plan on adding even more to it. The sky is what I just got.
added.
Oh, yeah.
And I plan on getting some more Japanese, and then I want to stretch it on across down to my...
And why the Japanese? Why do you...
Because I don't want people to really know what it says. I don't know.
I just think it's a beautiful written language.
Yeah, you know? Yeah.
It's so much more beautiful and flowing than the American alphabet, I think. So for me, it just kind of looks really good. It's like art.
Yeah.
Our friend Dirt in Los Angeles did these.
Yeah, he's the bass player from Society One.
Cool. And does he have a studio or he just tattoos?
Well, at the time he was working. Well, actually, he was working at Devil Doll Studio, and then they closed down because the owner of this studio decided to have this like bounty hunter reality show. Oh. And then so he moved to like LA studio
on Hollywood Boulevard.
And now he's just kind of, he's trying to get into that LA Inc., that TV show in America, so hopefully, I don't know.
And how about getting the same tattoos? I don't mean to be really negative here, but you always see like people that are married and things go wrong, you know, and then they go, no, I got the tattoos. I mean, you guys are obviously sickly in love.
Yeah.
I'm kidding. I mean, was it a big decision to get these done, or you seem to be planning more to get
this done? It wasn't a decision for me at all. It was very simple. I'm the kind of guy who said, I'll never get married. You know, I'm afraid of commitment. And after being with her for just a couple months, we were like, let's get married. I mean, we're very sure about it. And we're together every minute of every day for the last 2 years.
Yeah.
And we're absolutely inseparable, so I don't see anything going wrong. And you know, even if it's something it did, it's like, it wouldn't matter. I would love her forever, no matter what happens.
So it's like it's like a part of your life right now or whatever. And have you got any plans to get any tattoos that, like, solo tattoos?
Well, I'm going to get the rest, you know, done. But he wants to get, because these are uneven, he wants to get our names done to kind of flow with this.
You're big into symmetry then.
Yeah. I'm very I'm very weird like that. I have to be even.
And I mean, how about like your arms and stuff? Because most guys in big bands, big hardcore bands,
Well,
he's a minimalist.
I'm a minimalist. I really am.
I like girls. You make you get tattoos.
I'm changing him so much. It's crazy.
Yeah. I like, for the longest time, I thought, well, every band has tattoos, you know? So, like, I look different because I don't have tattoos.
Yeah.
So, I don't think I'll ever do any big sleeves or anything like that.
But do you think that because you kind of got the taste for
I'm too old for that stuff.
Ah, come on now. You're only 25. Cool. Well, thanks so much for talking to us. And best of luck with the rest of the tattoos.
Thanks.